And we are back with some more LA Kings franchise mode. And in this one, we are facing the San Jose Sharks. Looking at their lineup here, there's nothing I'm too threatened by their forward core. I mean, they have a lot of depth, but obviously nothing that is going to be too threatening offensively, at least single-handedly. Looking at the defensive core, they have Carlson, of course, who is going to be a threat from the back end, but not much else. So I'm not too worried. And then you also have Ranta and Jones in net. Doesn't matter who they have an 83 in net. A very deep team, but not too much star power. So certainly not anything that we can't contend with. So as we take a look at our lines, we pretty much match up with them, I would say, on most lines, if not all of them. Because we have a bunch of 85s and 86s, a bunch of mid-80s players on our top nine, really. And then even our fourth line, I think, might be a little bit better than theirs. And on defense, I mean, we have them covered with Doughty, who is a 92. That beats out Carlson's 88. And honestly, on defense, I think, unless they have some chemistry in there, I think we're better on defense. We really are, especially with that plus five with Spence and Hjalmarsson. We are looking good. And then you got Markkanen and Shesterkin. Overall-wise, they have Markkanen beat, but Markkanen, I think, deserves the start for game number one because he has been solid this year. As we take a look at the save percentage, 909. Four shutouts, and if we take a look at Shesterkin, 906 in 40 games. He had one shutout, or actually, no, that was from last year's playoffs, it looks like. This year he had an 898 with one shutout. So I believe that Mr. Markkanen deserves the chance to start, and scratched our quick Goligoski and Amadio. That being said, let us get into game number one here versus the San Jose Sharks. In our first playoff series of the GM mode. Here we go. First period. And that'll be 1-1. Okay. Olofsson with the power play goal. And LeBanc on Markkanen. So, pretty even game so far. Like that I'm seeing Olofsson scoring. That means that second line that was our offensive powerhouse in the regular season continues to score here in the playoffs, at least so far. Second period. Ooh. Hate to see it. Deneau and Vlasic on Markkanen. Shots are still pretty even, 20-19, but the score is 3-1. Don't like to see it. Third period. Come on, boys. There you go. Vilardi with the goal. Back to within one. Power play for San Jose. Nice kill. Another power play for San Jose. Nice kill. And Byfield with the game-tying goal on Ranta. 5 minutes remaining. 3-2-1. We have overtime. Now, obviously, this could be a long series, so for the time being, we are going to just simulate the overtime. Not going to go into it. We're just going to see who wins in the simulation. Come on, get the shots on net. I don't like what I'm seeing right now from the San Jose side of things, and yep, Donato with the goal on Markkanen. So that was unfortunate. Three studs of the game are Vlasic, Gambrell, and Donato. I mean, there's not really much to say. Erik Haula injured with a sore foot until April 17th. Once again, unfortunate. But as I was saying, I mean, that game spoke for itself, really, because it appears that they outshot us in basically every period. Still, I would have liked to see a better performance from Markkanen. It's not entirely his fault, but we did get three goals, so I'll give him the benefit of the doubt. I'll give him one more game, and then if he has another game like that, I think we'll go to Shesterkin, see what he can do. But for the time being, it looks like we're going to have to fill in Amadio. So now we have Carter on that line with Ho and Kessel. Unfortunately, you get the minus one there, but hopefully Carter, being the veteran presence, will help out that line more than he's hurting it. And here we go into game number two, still in San Jose. Down 1-0 in the series. Could be 2-0 by the end of this game, or it could be 1-1. First period. All right, I'll take it. We're out shooting them now. 13-8. Looking good so far, but I would prefer to see a goal on there for your LA Kings. Second period, still nothing. So they outshot us in that period. We're still out shooting them in total, but they had more shots in that period alone. The players got to play, and they got to convert on a chance here, because if we fall down 2-0, it's going to be shaky the rest of the way for sure. I'm not saying it's impossible that we won't be able to win this series, but it's going to be a massive uphill battle. And there's a goal immediately, basically, by Gamble, and then Meyer on the power play on Markkanen. Broberg, okay. Yeah, that's unfortunate. You hate to see it. Power play for LA? Nope. Yeah. It was fine up until the third period, and then things started to unwind a little bit for San Jose, and we get shutouts. And I think I'm going to take Markkanen out. It's not that he didn't do well overall. It's just the timing of when he let in these goals, especially that goal by Gamble in the first, within the first minute of the period, and then Meyer soon after. I think he's showing that 81 overall. So I think we're going to put Shesterkin in there now. There we go. Shesterkin is in. And actually, I'm just going to make sure that automated goalie rotations are off just so we don't have any nonsense happening here. All right, going into the Staples Center for the first time these playoffs. Down 2-0 in the series. Not looking good for us at the moment. But if we don't win this one, then it really will not be looking good. So we absolutely need this win. Let's get to it. And get me a goal within the first 5 minutes, I'm going to say. I'm going to just do the slow sim to start out because I want to see if we can get a goal here soon. No, we can't. Okay. Just simming the rest of the period. And Couture with the goal on Shesterkin. Makes it 1-0. Shots are 8-8. So not too much offense in that period for either team, but they got the goal. Second period, nothing doing. I'm not liking what I'm seeing from the offense here. That is now 5 periods in a row at least without a goal. You just absolutely hate to see it. The shots are 20-19 in favor of San Jose. Scores 1-0 also in favor of San Jose. Power play for San Jose. Nothing doing. Nice kill. Another power play. Nice kill. Come on. 5 minutes remaining. 4-3-2. Vilardi with the goal. And 1. We are headed to overtime. Okay. Thank you, Vilardi. Will we be down 2-1? Or will we go down 3-0 and have almost no chance in this series? Come on now. 34 shots apiece. No one's really doing anything right now. Get something going here, boys. Come on. 10 minutes remaining. Power play. There it is. Hjalmarsson, of all people. with the overtime goal on Raanta. And the 3 stars of the game, of course, the goaltenders are going to be on there. Shesterkin and Raanta, and then Hjalmarsson with the 3rd star. So we definitely needed that win. And it wasn't a pretty win by any means, but we got the W. That's what matters. And, you know, Shesterkin did a good job, so he is staying in there for game number 4. All right, here we go. Game number 4 starting. First period. Russ with the goal. Shesterkin. Shots are 10-7. Not liking what I'm seeing. Once again, that is a pattern I'm noticing at the moment, is we seem to just not be able to get any shots on net within the first 40 minutes. So let's try to change that here in the second. Second period, nope. Ugh. Ugh. No. Donato with the power play goal. Shots are 22-15. So not looking good. I think we might be due for some line changes after this game. And honestly, I'm not sure what those would be, considering I believe we have our best lines together at the moment, and they clearly aren't doing anything for us as Meyer scores. Yeah, this is not looking good. And 4-0, goal by Hamonic. I mean, Carter scores on Raanta, but it's not looking good here. It's really not. 1 minute remaining, and we're down 3-1. 3 stars of the game, Raanta, Donato, and Rust. All right, let's check out the stats here. Let's see if we can turn this around. I'm not hopeful, but who knows? Crazier things have happened. So Kessel with 3 assists, no goals. Vilardi with 2 goals, no assists. I think Vilardi might have been one of the only guys who have scored so far. As we take a look at goals, yeah, only 2 goals for Vilardi, and then 1 for Olofsson, Carter, Hjalmarsson, and Byfield, and none from anybody else. Yeah, that's a problem. That is definitely a problem. Let's see, are we winning faceoffs? Are we winning faceoffs? Yeah, Turcotte's getting, he's winning 63%. Kopitar is at 62.7, so I don't think faceoffs are a problem. At least not for anyone who isn't named Jeff Carter. But still, what's the issue here then? I think it's just got to be goal scoring in general and shots, possibly, as we take a look at total shots. Olofsson with 18, Turcotte with 14. Yeah, not a whole lot going on offensively here. Ooh, Doughty's a -5. That's, I don't tend to take plus minus with too much consideration, but when there's it's like that, it's worrying. Yeah, Shesterkin's got to be the man here. 939 save percentage compared to 888. That's like a complete 180 compared to the regular season for these two. So we're going to keep rolling Shesterkin. He's been doing well. It's just the team around him is failing to score right now. I hate to break up that second line from where they are, but I feel like maybe just given increased ice time, the game will favor them. And I actually don't even lose that +3. They maintain it. So let's see what they can do in that first line, because these guys were our best line all year, and they're only getting 15 minutes of ice time. Well, in Byfield's case, anyway. Turcotte's actually getting 19 minutes a night. Olofsson, 1740. I'll move Vilardi to the middle, and I think it's time to drop Kopitar down to the third line, because he's just not really getting it done there on that first line. So we'll try Kessel, Vilardi, and Ehlers, and then Ho, Carter, and Kopitar. So switching up the lines a little bit. And on as far as defense, Doughty and Manson. I want to change something up about that pair, but if we move Hjalmarsson up with Manson, we lose that +5 for Spence. Yeah, there's really not much we can do defensively that would make things any better. Because, I mean, you can move Clegg up there to get a +1, and you maintain the +3 with Anderson. But you're also moving an 81 up there with Doughty as opposed to having an 85. So that's, for me, that seems pointless. So we may as well just stick with what we have on defense. As for the power play, let's take a look at the power play and the penalty kill. I wouldn't imagine the penalty kill is doing too bad. It's the power play that I'm worried about. Yeah, that needs to change. 1.5 goals for per game. That is brutal. And power play, yep. Yep, 8.3. That's unfortunate. Yeah, as I figured, the penalty kill's doing fine. They're 87.5. It's just the power play that is just god awful. So let's see what we can do about the power play here. I think we might honestly have to take Kopitar off, because he's not doing anything offensively right now. Only problem is, who would I put on there instead? Maybe Vilardi moves to the center position, and then I guess maybe you could keep Kopitar on the point. It's not like he's bad defensively. But then again, he does have a 90 for faceoffs. He has been winning the draws. How's Vilardi doing on faceoffs? He has a 62.5. Okay, so we'll go Turcotte and Vilardi down the middle. And then on defense, you have Spence, Anderson, Doughty, Carter, maybe? I mean, he does match the penalty or the power play line chemistry, so yeah, we'll try him there. And instead of Kopitar on the 4-on-4, or the 4-man power play, rather, we will put Keith Ho. All right, changes have been made. Backs against the wall in San Jose. No pressure, just get out there and play. First period? Okay. I mean, we got offense at the first period. I think that deserves a round of applause. So you have Olofsson on Ranta, but then Lehkonen and Ferraro answer. But then Kupari, with roughly 5 minutes remaining in the first, gets us back and tied at 2. Shots are 15-10. So looking good so far. I mean, we equaled our shot total from the last game at the end of the second, because I think we only had 15 shots at the end of the second last game. So already looking good. But I would prefer to keep them off the board as well. That being said, second period time. There you go. That is what I've been waiting for. Hjalmarsson, Clegg, and Ho on Ranta. More of that, please. Third period. Power play for San Jose. Goes nowhere. Come on, LA. There you go. Victor Olofsson with the goal on the power play makes it 6-2. And we finally have an offensive explosion of a game. The hurdle scores on Shesterkin with roughly 5 minutes remaining, but it didn't matter, too little too late for San Jose. And we win 6-3. And Spence with 4 assists. Wow. So we're still down 3-2, but we're in a slightly better spot than we were before. So I will certainly take it. Eric Halla is also back. So I want to get him back in. What's Amadio done? 1 assist. +1. What's his takeaways and giveaways looking like? He's basically just been an empty presence out there. It's not like he's even won a face. He has 1 assist. That's nothing that Howla can't do. So, yeah, we're going to get Howla back in there. And I think I might keep him on the fourth line just because Ho scored in that last game. So I think I want to keep that third line together for the time being. So yeah, it'll be Haula, Kupari, and Brown on the fourth line. All right, game number six. Let's hope for more of the same. First period. Okay. Once again, a goal in the first period. You like to see it. Phil Kessel on the power play, and then Donato on Shesterkin. So relatively even game. Second period. There you go, Keith Ho once again on Ranta. And we are out shooting them 18-14. Score is 2-1. Okay. It's looking good. Give me one more. There it is. Ehlers right on cue. And give me one more for insurance. There it is. Right on cue once again. Phil Kessel. Am I like psychic this game or something? But nonetheless, we have a 3-goal lead in the third period, and it's looking like we could be headed to a game 7. Not going to jinx it just yet, but that is now the case. We are headed to game 7. Let's go. Restarts the game. Kessel, Shesterkin, and Ho. All right, here we go. Game 7. Not making any changes. The lines have been working the past couple games. Goaltending's been great. So Shesterkin, keep at it. Offense, get me at least 3. Please, at least 3. First period. Haula with the first goal of the game. Shots are 12-11, but this time we have a 1-goal lead. Second period. Okay, we still have a 1-goal lead. Hurdle scores on the power play, but Phil Kessel on Ranta makes the lead 2-1. Heading into the third period. Shots are actually 29-22 in favor of San Jose, so they poured them on in that period, but we have the 1-goal advantage. Third period underway. Power play. Hate to see it. Get me that insurance marker, LA. There it is. Keith Ho with the goal. Probably the biggest goal of his career so far. And is that going to be it? Power play once again. Nothing doing. That's fine as long as we hold the lead. And we do. We move on to the second round. Unbelievable. 3 stars of the game. Shesterkin, Ho, and Kessel. Keith Ho with the, I believe that was a 3-game scoring streak, because he definitely scored last game, and I'm pretty sure he scored in that 6-3 win as well. So yeah, Keith Ho, whatever happened there, I guess maybe he likes playing with Kopitar, because ever since we moved Kopitar onto his line, he is certainly getting it done, is Keith Ho. So, in surprise fashion, your LA Kings are now off to the second round. But what really surprised me about that series is that the first line of Byfield, Turcotte, and Olofsson was quieter than I thought it would be. Byfield only had 1 point. Turcotte had 5 assists, so that was pretty decent. Olofsson had 3 goals and an assist, but not as active as I thought for sure. Phil Kessel really turned it on. 3 goals and 3 assists. Great deadline acquisition there. And then Keith Ho, of course, with 3 goals and 2 assists. All 3 of those goals came in the last 3 games. And even Kopitar didn't really have... He only had 2 assists. One of those came from the first line. I don't know if it was Kopitar that affected Ho's simulation or what. Maybe Ho just decided to turn it on. It was time to turn it on. I don't know how that works, but whatever. I'm not complaining. All that matters is that in the end, we won the series. And Igor Shesterkin, he definitely turned it around from the regular season. He had an .898 save percentage in the regular season, but comes up huge with a .942 in the first round of the playoffs, and we move on to the second round. I mean, some really clutch performances in there for him. Definitely the go-to guy so far in these playoffs, and I think, I would like to hope anyway, that he will be for the remainder of these playoffs. Oh, and honorable mention, Jordan Spence with 6 assists in the series. I mean, that was certainly a standout performance from the kid. And who do we have now in the second round? We have the Vancouver Canucks, who are 45-36-1 on the regular season. 6-4 in their last 10, of course, during the regular season as well. So let's check out the Vancouver Canucks lines, and we'll end things off. So the first line, oh boy, not looking forward to this one. Virtanen, Pettersson, and Besser. Second line is Horvat, Miller, and Lind. Third line is Furland, Jonathan Toews, and Harluk. And then Nygaard, Gaudet, and Maroon. Oh my goodness. Quinn Hughes, and then PK Subban as well. Juolevi and Myers, and then Schmidt and Sherratt in goal. You have DiPietro and Hill. scratched our reader, Ouellette, and Ben. So a lot that I'm scared about with this team. Pettersson, Besser, Hughes. So that being said, I'll end things off here. And the next one, we'll be facing the Vancouver Canucks in the second round. See you guys then.